Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Okay, so today, as you know, is Good Friday, and Good Friday is the day that Jesus Christ went to the cross to die in our place. And this day just is so special to me. This is like the most special day of the year, and I just like to be in remembrance of what He did for us. And He went to the cross and died in our place. And He was without sin. He didn't deserve to die, but He did it because He loved the world and He didn't want us to have to live with the burdens of our sins every day and be weighed down by the things that we do wrong on a daily basis. And he wanted us to know that He is going to sacrifice His body and Himself, even though He is without sin, to save you from the daily burdens of your own sins. And that is very, very special to me. There's nothing more special in this world than the death of Jesus Christ in our place. And I just, every year, I like to sit down and watch The Passion of the Christ. It's the movie that shows just the hours up into His death. And you really get the feel for what He went through, and I like to sit down and I like to feel that pain that He had to go through, because it just reminds you of how far you have to go in life to like really understand, and just shows you, like, it humbles you. It reminds you that someone else took the place of what you deserve. And that is the greatest love of all, of anything that I've ever known. I don't think that humans are quite capable of that type of love. But so many things are going on in this world right now. And there's so much hate, especially online with social media. And being able to just say things to people that you want, that for some reason you feel like it's okay to say online, but you would not say that to someone in real life. Well, social media is people's real lives, and using that to further the work of the devil is not okay with me. Like, we have got to learn to love each other. The one thing that God wanted from us is love. All He wanted us to do is love each other. That's all we have to do in His, like, so His death can be worth something to Him. Like, He wanted us to just love each other. Why is that so hard for us to do? I don't understand. It's, people can hurt you. People can say mean things to you. We are human beings and we make mistakes on the daily. On the minute, we make mistakes. And don't let one of your friends or family members' mistake of saying something that they shouldn't say to you, don't let that hinder your relationship with them. Because if God or Jesus Christ could die in place of our sins, and people hurt Him so badly and He didn't deserve it, and He still could forgive us, why can we not forgive the human that said something to hurt us? Or, like, you don't want to lose your relationship with somebody because they said something to hurt you. Instead of, like, cutting them off or just letting them go and being like, I just don't need them as a friend anymore, why don't you just turn around and pray for them and say, you know, what they said really hurt me, and Lord, I ask You to forgive them. They don't understand how much it hurt my feelings, and I hope that You can forgive them, and I forgive them, and I want to keep them in my life. So just show them that, you know, I was hurt by it, and try that before you just cut them off, you know. We're a generation of being very, like, self-centered. Like, we care too much about how other people treat us, and sometimes we forget to stop and look at ourselves and as how we treat other people. And it makes me feel sad that the Lord had to die in our place for these sins. And we can't turn around and give Him what He asked for. The only thing He asked out of us is for love. Me and my husband, we really are kind of into these near-death experiences where people have actually like died and seen the other side, and some have even talked to Jesus, and little kids, like that movie, the one with the little girl that fell in the tree, like she saw the other side. These are children, and like all the accounts have like the same kind of way about them. And there was one that just kind of resonates with us, and his name is Howard Storm, and he had a big impact. His story had a big impact on me and my husband's life. And he said, I don't quote me exactly because I'm terrible at paraphrasing or quoting somebody else, but he asked Jesus while he was on the other side, like, what our mission in life, or what should we do? And the only thing that Jesus told him was, love the one you're with. And he was like, that's it? Like, that's all? And he's like, yeah. And so Jesus has taught so many people that all he wants out of us in return of this huge thing that he did for us is for us to love someone else. And the next time someone does something to you that you feel like is hurting, my preacher, like, one time said, if there's something that I say in church that you don't agree with or you don't like, he said, don't not come, just pray for me that I get an understanding. And I thought that was so enlightening, to think, like, don't cut people off. Don't cut them out of your life. Give them opportunities. They are just human beings, the same as you. And I just want love for this world. I want us to all come together, every age, every race, every gender out there. I mean, everybody in this world that feels like the world is against you. I just want us all to come together and just be respectful of each other. Don't let everything that someone says to you hurt your feelings. And if it does hurt your feelings, pray about it rather than hurting them back or cutting them off. That's just all I want for this world. I want to see us all in the presence of the Lord one day, everybody. And I feel like we should accept people for who they are. The Bible is there. The rules are set. There's no need in chastising someone because they're not following it accordingly. Because if you take a look at your own life, usually you're not following it accordingly either. So before you stop and judge someone else and what they're doing, just kind of take a look at yourself and make sure that you're following all the rules before you pick a certain rule out of the Bible and chastise someone for not following that rule. So usually, as humans, we don't follow the rules all the way we're supposed to. And so I just ask that before you look at someone else's life, maybe like you might want to look in the mirror and look at your own. And trust me, I have to do that a lot. Like if I feel upset about someone, I have to like do a self evaluation. You know what I'm saying? Like I need to sit down and look at myself before I judge. And I'm so hard on my poor husband. You know, like I expect so much out of him, and then like I forget sometimes to stop and look at myself and look at my faults and things. And I think that's what keeps a good marriage and good friendships and good family is the love and acceptance of the other person, and making sure that you stop and look at yourself before you sit there and judge them. And so I just think it's a good year of learning to love again and not walking away from people and problems, like not walking away from a marriage or friendships or family. Just remember that you're going to go through hard times. You're going to go through times where you don't like each other. That's just how it goes. But don't cut them off completely. Like, let things sit, let pray, forgive, and just remember every time that you don't want to forgive somebody for something they've done, just remember Jesus Christ on that cross, Him beaten and bloody and His death. Remember that, and it makes the problems of the world seem a lot less important. So just remember to pray for others, and remember to keep love in your heart for other people, even when they hurt you. Just keep the love there, and everything else will fall into place. So I just feel like that in my life, I don't understand everything about the Bible, but one thing I do understand is that Jesus died for us, and He wants us to love others. That's all. Like, that's the basis of my religion. It's pretty simple, right? Like, it's the hardest job in the world to love someone that hurts you or that you don't know or that says a mean comment or something. If you read a mean comment where someone says, something ugly or something racial, like, that's such a huge problem now. And when you read a comment about that, like, or someone being ugly to another person or another type of person or color of person, just remember that God made us all to love each other. That's all. He just wants to us to love Him and other people. Like, that's all you have to do. And as hard as it can be at sometimes, just humble yourself and remember that you're not perfect. And that's just, I mean, I have the most simple religion ever. I don't even know what that it would even be called. Like, I just, that's like the basis to my whole life. I mean, is just love other people. And I get to see the best and the worst of people. I get, I'm a nurse, so I see people at their best day and I see people at their worst day. And I just want to remember that I want to be a comfort to those people, whether they're mad, whether they're happy, sad, whether they're upset. It's good to know that you can be the light for someone. So try it. Try, like, if you see someone down, ask them what's wrong. Be there to pick them up if they want to talk to you, or just be that voice of, or just the person sitting there quietly listening to someone else. Just be that for someone, and I promise you, good things will come to you. Just if you love and accept and are just a shining light for others. But anyways, let me wrap this up because I know I drag on. I don't know exactly what I want to say. I just sit down in this chair and just pray that God gets whatever message He can through me, because I'm not very articulate with the words sometimes, especially when it comes to religion, because I'm not that smart on it. I get a lot of what I learn through my husband, and so I don't know the words to say sometimes, but I just wanted you guys to know that Jesus wants us to love each other, and He loves you, and today is a very special day. They say at 3 p.m., that's when He officially died on the cross that day, and that's a special hour because He made the ultimate sacrifice for us, and I couldn't thank Him enough. So just remember today as a very special day, and give somebody a hug, tell them you love them in Jesus Christ, and I will talk to you guys later.